Hey kids in Paris, this is Scott Jenkins, and I have a quick little announcement before we start our video today. My job and my service and my calling is to obey what Paul tells us in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 4. And my job is to help you as parents to bring up your children in the training and instruction of the Lord. And so since that's my calling, I want to give you ways to help you do that. So along with this video, I'm going to be sending some resources that you can talk about with your kids and have conversations with them. So kids, help your mom and dad out and do these questions with them. If you need help getting these questions, you can email me at scottjenkins@hotmail.com, and I would be more than happy to get them to you. And moms and dads, be praying about how God is going to use these lessons to teach your kids to come up in the way that God wants them to. And so, with that, enjoy. Imagine you're playing some basketball, and your coach tells you, "All right, players, here's how we're gonna win the game. We're gonna pass the ball back and forth, round and round in a circle for the whole game. All right, so that's how we're gonna win. It's gonna work out. 1, 2, 3, basketball!" That wouldn't make much sense, would it? Sometimes God tells us to do things that, at the beginning, don't really make much sense. And he did that with Joshua and the Israelites as they were coming into the town of Jericho. God had promised the Israelites that they were going to come into a new land that they could call their own. And he also promised that the people who were living there were going to be driven out because they were doing evil things. They were very bad people. So God promised that he was going to make sure this happened. But God gave the Israelites some really weird instructions for taking over one of the towns called Jericho. He told the Israelites, "Go around the city every day for 7 days. Just everybody march around the whole town." Now, the town of Jericho had a big wall all the way around it, and so they couldn't just walk in and take the town. So God told them to walk around this big wall. In front of them, they had the Ark of the Covenant, which was the box that God told the Israelites to make to put the Ten Commandments in. And that would go in front of the whole Israelite army as they would go around the walls of Jericho. And on the seventh day, God said, "Go around the city 7 whole times." Now, if you were the Israelites, you were probably thinking, "Wait a minute, God, how are we going to take over this town when we're just walking around it? They could shoot us with bow and arrows while we're walking around, and we're kind of wasting a week because we're not fighting these people. How is this going to work, God?" Sometimes God wants to show off, really. God wants to show his power. He wants to show that it's not by what people can do, but it's by what God can do. It's not by someone who's strong or smart or better than other people, but it's by God and his power that he wants to accomplish everything that God calls us to do. And so as the Israelites were walking around, God was saying, "I'm going to show my power and not let you rely on your power." All right, well, we are going to do an activity today talking about going around the wall 7 times. And so if you have blocks or anything else you'd like to stack at home, go ahead and stack it up like this. And then, as you see, my helpers here are walking around it 7 whole times. So as you stack something, walk around it 7 times. Once you walk around your tower 7 times, shout, "The Lord is with us," and then break it down. After 6 days of marching around the city and wondering what God was doing, here's what happened on the seventh day. The Bible tells us on the seventh day, they got up at daybreak and marched around the city 7 times in the same manner, except that on that day, they circled the city 7 times. The seventh time around, when the priest sounded the trumpet blast, Joshua shouted and commanded the people, "Shout, for the Lord has given you the city." And then later it says, "When the trumpet sounded, the people shouted. And at the sound of the trumpet, when the people gave a loud shout, the wall collapsed so that every man charged straight in and they took the city."
The trumpet sounded and the army gave a mighty war cry. And the walls collapsed.
God gave weird directions, but God came through. And the walls of the city, big stone rock walls, came tumbling down. And God's people were able to take the city for themselves. So God sometimes gives directions and instructions and commandments that may seem weird. And this happens in our own life, right? Sometimes God is telling us to love people who are mean to us. Sometimes God tells us to be kind to those who aren't kind to us and pray for those who are mean to us. Sometimes God tells us to go and help someone that everyone else is laughing at. God tells us to obey our parents even when we think that they're wrong. God tells us to love him and worship him and obey him even if everyone else around us doesn't even believe in God. God sometimes gives weird directions, but we are to listen. We're to listen to the Holy Spirit speaking to us. We're to listen to God's word, even if the world around us says something totally opposite. Because when we listen to God, God comes through. When we obey God and do the strange things that he tells us to do, God blesses us. God sent his son Jesus to earth. And it's strange that Jesus would come for sinners like you and like me. But he did. He obeyed God. It's weird that Jesus would live the perfect life so people who didn't live the perfect life could go to heaven and live forever. But Jesus did that. It was weird for God to ask Jesus to die, to be punished for our sins when we deserve to be punished. And Jesus didn't deserve it, but he did. And God blessed Jesus and rose him from the dead and seated him in his right hand forever and ever. And everyone who calls on Jesus, who believes in him, gets to be saved, gets to come into the heavenly city and be with him forever. Sometimes God's instructions are weird, but God's going to win the game. Our strength isn't going to. But God says, thank you for joining me today, and may God bless you.